Okay, so I want to show you something really quick that I found out over my lunch hour here. And so I'm going to go into ChatGPT, and we're going to basically create a presentation from scratch here. So I'm going to enter in taking some insights from an existing strategic plan. This is from Union City, which is one I found online. I'm going to copy this, go back into ChatGPT, paste it, and kind of summarize this. Let's see what ChatGPT does. It's going to use Ask My PDF or Ask Your PDF plugin here. Oh, cool. So this is actually cool because sometimes you have trouble with Chrome extensions or things like that if the PDF is part of a Chrome extension. So it gives the option to be able to upload your document to this site. So I can come over here, open this. As you can see, it's a Chrome extension. I'm going to download this real quick here and then go back here, click on here, and now it's going to give me an option to be able to upload that document and get a doc ID for this. So I'm going to click on here, going to upload it. I'm uploading it off slide, off screen here, but it's been uploaded. You can see the screen moving. And then it's going to generate a doc ID that I can put. Yep, there it is. I'm going to copy this. And all I have to do is come into ChatGPT and paste it right in there. So there we go. And now it's using Ask Your PDF again plugin. There's two plugins for this. There's Ask Your PDF and also Chat with PDF. I haven't found one to be better than the other. Sometimes the system goes down, so I kind of switch between the two plugins. And here it is. It's kind of gave me the details of the strategic plan. This is awesome. So really helpful to quickly summarize documents. And let's say, you know, I'm looking at these goals. Let's say I want some more details on these goals. So let's ask it for that. Okay, provide more details on the goals. It's thinking here again. It's going to ask the PDF again, look at it, and should give me a summary or more, kind of a more breakdown details of these goals. As it kind of goes to the document, pulls out all the information. Doing some more here. But now this is, I like these plugins. If you haven't played around with the plugins before, definitely take a look at them and play around with them. As you can see, right, so pull up and what this system is doing now, you can see it's grabbing the text from the document there. It's pretty cool. These plugins are great. It's available for those who have ChatGPT 4, which I think is like a $20 a month subscription. It's not terrible. I think it's really worth it. I've used it a lot. There's a cap of 25 prompts or messages for every 3 hours, I think. I've run into it a couple times, but also you can just revert back to ChatGPT 3.5, the default model, if that comes up. So here it is. It's giving me all the summary of the goals. This is great. And it goes through each individual one here. It's going to give me a synopsis of each individual one as it's generating this from that PDF text. And here we go. Goal E looks like. Okay, that should be the final one. Perfect. Exactly what we wanted there. Great. Now, let's say we want to, maybe we want to add more for, you know, maybe the next round of strategic plan, the next 5 years, right? So let's have ChatGPT generate that for us. Let's have it go through and do that here. And I think it ended in 2019, but let's double check to make sure we have the right dates here. Let's scroll up real quick to make sure we have the right dates. Okay, yep, so we need 25 to 30. So let's go down there, let's do 2025 to 2030. Okay, we're gonna put that in there and have it generate those goals for us for the next 5 years for our strategic plan. So now it's gonna think through again what it wants to do. Yep, so here's some goals. Here we go. All right, just kind of basic level things here. Well, what we should do, you know, as we look over this, okay, these are pretty decent, you know, in terms of kind of builds on what the last 5 years were, similar topics, kind of taking maybe some next steps with that on each of these different goals that was already identified in the Union City Strategic Plan for 2019 to 2025. So kind of the next step there from 2020 to 25, now 25 to 30, next 5 years. Great. So perfect. That's exactly what we wanted there. But I think probably need a little more detail on the strategic plan. Like, how do we actually accomplish this goal? So let's ask ChatGPT to help us do that here. Okay, I'll put this in here. Okay, there we go. And now it's going to identify maybe some action, some steps we can take for this, which is exactly what we want to do. We want to have these steps be more actionable. And obviously you could do this, you could drill down to each individual one. Right? It says create a strategy for, right? You could have ChatGPT literally create that strategy for you and kind of, you know, combine a running document, really build a strategic plan straight through this this ChatGPT. I would say if you're using ChatGPT to do this part of it, I'm kind of wasting some of my prompts on GPT-4. I'm not using the plugins. This can also be generated through the 3.5 model as well too, so you might want to switch back. I'm not doing it for right now, but something to think about if you're using GPT-4, switch back to GPT-3.5 in a separate thread maybe and have it develop the goals for you and the strategic plan for you. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go through and we're going to create a presentation for this, right? We have the goals here, we have the previous goals, or the new goals for 25 to 30. So we're going to create the VBA code that's going to write the presentation automatically for us in PowerPoint. And that way we can take this and say we want to present this to, you know, our city leadership, whatever it is. We can take these goals identified, create a presentation, and have them do that. So it's going to think here, going to think things through. Yep, I get it. But there we go. Now it's going to go through and create the VBA code for it. And really, I don't know anything about coding, so I'm not sure what this exactly means. All I know is it works out pretty cool, I'm excited to show you what this does. So it's going to go through, write the code for it. I've had issues in the past where the code was wrong, but it's a really easy fix. All I have to do is put in the error and where the error is at into ChatGPT, and it'll rewrite the code for you and fix those errors. It's actually relatively simple on how it can do that. Pretty easy to work with and to use. Okay, now I don't quite like the way this works. Let's put some more in here. I really want it to use the text already identified before to create these goals and create the text for the PowerPoint. Let's have it do that here. Okay, it's gonna think this through. Here we go, write the code again. And like I said before, the plugins are pretty fun to work with. There's a lot of different plugins and new ones are being added like every single day. It's pretty wild. When I first started using it, there was, I think, 11 pages of plugins, and now it's up to 27 different pages of plugins in the plugins library. All kinds of different stuff in there. It's pretty remarkable, everything it has in there, all they can do. So here we go. Great. Now let's say we want to add in the ones from the previous strategic plan, 25 or 2025. Let's add that into the presentation here too. Okay, I'll have it do that. It's going to think it through. It's using Ask Your PDF because looking back on that goal before. Okay, let's just give me the summary of these goals. Might have to ask it to go through and actually write the code again. Let's see what it does here. It's summarizing these goals once again. Kind of repetitive, but we'll bear with it for a second here. So go through, kind of just kind of parsing the information out and putting this in here. So like I said, a lot of great tools for document creation. All the things you can do in terms of being able to generate this text, summarize documents, even videos too. There's a video plugin for chat with video. Oh, cool! It is actually increased in doing the code for me too. Perfect. Exactly what I wanted to. Didn't need the first part of it, but we took the scenic route to get here, which is fine. So while it's doing that, let me go show you how to get your developer tab up and running here. So go to your options here. I'm gonna go to customize ribbon. Mine is already checked on it, but you can look at this developer tab. I'm gonna check it, and there you go. And that's how you get to your developer tab. Let's go back to here to see if it's finished yet. Still generating, still running the code for it. Great, okay. Blah, 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 blah. Oh man, it says place to our text. I want it to fill its own text in. So let me grab that real quick here and have it actually fill in the text for me. So like I said, so with the chat with your video thing, you can take a video and you can put the video link and it can summarize the video for what it's, you know, what the video is all about. In fact, I just did that with Ron Hollifield's latest 10 and 10. And right away it pulled the video in, recognized that he had quoted President Kennedy about civility not being weakness, and it summarized that for me in about 3 seconds. Wasn't a long video, still worth watching. I encourage you all to watch it too. His 10 and 10 series is great. But quickly summarizes those videos for that as well too. One thing I'm playing with right now is trying to figure out how to get videos that are transcripts. So let's go over here. So if we look at the developer tab, you can see that click macros or VBA, insert new module, and here's where we're gonna paste that in there. Let's go back over here. Oh, didn't generate the response, okay. So like I was saying before, you can take the transcripts from like YouTube videos, copy that into ChatGPT, and then have it create a summary for you as well, which we think would be really, really cool for clerks actually in creating minutes. If you have a system that already generates the transcripts for you or closed captioning for you, you can paste that into ChatGPT. Might need to do it in sections. You can just say, I have, you know, 20 prompts I'm gonna give you, don't do anything to the last prompt. You paste it in their sections, about 200-300 words per prompt is what I've noticed to be best results. No expert in that, just kind of my own personal experience. But you could take that, put them in the ChatGPT, those transcripts, and then have it generate minutes for you for your meeting minutes. So it's gonna write the code for me. You also do the same thing too if you have a video, like a YouTube video, maybe your live broadcast, council meetings or things like that. And so helpful for maybe like a work session, if you wanna have it summarize the work session for you and maybe pull out, you know, takeaways or you know, actions that council wants staff to take or next steps you need to look at, you know, in terms of more information. So let's copy this code into here. We're gonna go back into our PowerPoint presentation. I'm just gonna paste it and I'm gonna run it. And there it is, just like that. I'm gonna change the design of it, click this design. Obviously it's kind of formatted in a way that brings it down, but there we go. You can do that all the way down the line if you want to, but that should be it. Hope you enjoy.